to do it. I really shouldn't feel bad about breaking up with him, but the guilt follows me everywhere. I wasn't a bitch about it, was I? It's not so bad. Being on my own is freeing. But you know, one thing you notice when you're alone is how acutely aware you become of your surroundings. You start to notice things. Like when someone may be watching you.
Hi.
Oh my God, Greg.
It's good to see you. I thought we were gonna be friends. I brought some things for you.
I see that. You came prepared.
I've got a song. I've got some grievances set to song that I think you should hear.
I'm not so sure.
Okay, no, I get it.
What's wrong? We said we'd be friends.
Yeah, and I love friends. Listen, I'm a peach. I'm
yeah,
good.
Yeah, at the time you loved it. You thought it was a good idea.
And I can tell that this is weird.
A little.
And I'm not gonna be the crazy ex-boyfriend. That's not me. No. And I'm gonna go. I'm gonna give you the space you need.
Great.
Friendship commences now.
He won't leave me alone. Even when he's not here, I feel his presence. Everywhere I go, I hear a gentle knocking on my door. I don't know what it is. No one's there.
Hey, an audible gasp. That's a not a promising start.
Yeah.
I just let myself in. Force of habit, I guess. You must feel pretty weird right now.
Yeah, you're cooking?
I brought my microgreens for dinner tonight. You like those, right?
No.
Okay. Well, did you get my text about Space Jam?
Yeah, I got it.
That was funny, right?
It was funny.
Is there something wrong with your phone?
I didn't text you back.
Okay, I feel that, and I don't want to say this hurt worse for me, as the one cast aside, thrown to the wolves, as it were, when you broke up with me.
Again, I need space, Greg.
You're making this weird for me?
Greg, I'm sorry, I don't know what to say.
Okay.
No, Greg, I don't know how to do this.
You're making me feel kind of weird right now, and I don't like that feeling, so I'm gonna see my way out. We're gonna try this again some other time, and maybe you'll do a little better. Okay. I'm gonna leave the microgreens. Yeah. They not too much olive oil.
Bye.
I figured no one would be here at this hour, so I'd just like to get some alone time where we could talk about things for the past couple weeks. It's been kind of weird, and that's both our faults. But I've been knocking for a while. It's been like 8 hours.
You've been in the alley outside my bedroom for 8 hours.
But I wasn't knocking the whole time. Like I there was a point where I was sleeping. I've also, I think I ate one of these these like paint chip clippings that might have like hallucinogenic properties.
I don't think that's a good idea.
I'm feeling pretty zany right now. Look out, I'm crazy. That was a joke. This is normal for me. How do you feel?
I can't talk to you anymore.
Well, you mean like with me out here?
Greg, when I said I needed distance.
I like being in there. I miss your bedroom. You're kind of speechless right now. Is that like a swept off feet type emotion?
Okay. It's gone on long enough.
Like,
I've gotta go.
That was.
You should go.
That was like, I can come back
just
later.
Go away. I can't get rid of him. He's everywhere. There's no clean way to break it off without being really mean. I had to take drastic measures. I needed an expert.
All right. You're listening to Natural Instinct with the natural lover, Teddy Stillwater. We got Penelope from Richmond on the line. Go ahead, tell me what the problem is, Penelope.
Hi, yeah.
I'm calling because I have an ex-boyfriend who won't leave me alone. I need to find a way to put my foot down, but I don't want to come off as a...
A bitch? Look, you can't do that. He's gonna tell all his friends, and you're gonna be blacklisted. And this town is way, way too small for that. If you won't listen to reason, and he won't stop messing with you, there's only one thing to do. You gotta break it off naturally. Be real subtle about it, you know?
I'm willing to try anything.
All right. Tell Teddy his favorite thing about you.
Well, he likes my cooking a lot.
Okay. All right. This is what you gotta do. You gotta invite him over for dinner, and you gotta make something that you know he will not like.
It tastes kind of weird.
No, it's just pasta with red sauce.
Forget I said anything. It's yummy.
And then you gotta start acting unusual. And I mean crazy.
You know, I've just been doing a lot of thinking, and I'm realizing I'm more like my mother than I thought. You know, I'm really into quilting now, and like romance novels, and it's not like I'm menopausal, but I'm definitely like perimenopausal, you know, like I can really relate to her need to like, you know, have air conditioning on all the time, and I don't know, I really want to spend more time with her, just, you know, get to know her more. I feel like I've missed out. Greg? Is something wrong? Greg? Are you even listening to me? Oh my god. I killed him. Wait, is that good? I mean, I'm free, right? But every time I think I'm rid of him, I hear that fucking knock. Oh god. Now I can hear his moans. Alright. Get yourself together. You need another perspective right now.
Alright, listen. Disposing of the body is difficult work, alright? So, you're gonna need something sharp to start. Alright? Now what you gotta do is you gotta make the body portable. So, I advise you get them in there. Itty bitty little pieces. And you can do something with that. Now, that odor, it's gonna be difficult at first, but you'll get through it, baby. Don't worry. Penelope, still there?
Yeah.
turned into a zombie, hasn't he?
Yes.
There's only one thing to do. That head has got to go.
Look, I know we talked about phone time, but I'm having a lot of trouble opening this. Wait up. I'm not mad. I can get used to this. Being a zombie's almost as good as being human. I feel like with medication I can get back to pretty order. Together at last. Trying to kill me right now. That's weird. You're scaring me. Oh boy, I feel like I've made a big mess here. I feel.
Chop his head off? You know I ain't talking about the one on his shoulders, girl.
You want me to chop off his...
His dick, baby.
It's the only way that he'll leave the young lady alone.
I'm never touching that thing again.
Well, there's only one thing that you can do.